Hi, good evening everybody. Welcome to your Jubilant Saturday Part 2 video of Episode 571. And it's your Daily Bread passage. Today, for Saturday, December the 18th, 2021. 1 week till Christmas and 2 weeks till the new year arrives. Today we're going to be Well Done from David H. Roper from 2 Timothy 4, 1 through 8. If you're excited about this one, smash that like button, comment something that you plan to do in 1 week from today. What are your Christmas holiday plans? If it's something special, then, or if you're asking prayer for family travels or whatever, put that in the comment section and I'll be sure to pray for you. But darn it, I forgot to do something the other day. I forgot to put a comment in on a post that I shared, and I forgot to put somebody post comment to make him watch it. Oh, maybe after I get done recording, get everything loaded the way I want it, then I'll go back and find that post and comment and send it to him to tell him about it. So I forgot to do it, and I just realized it. So, but subscribe if you're new, turn on notifications, share the video and channel with your family and friends, and help me reach that goal of 100 subscribers by January the 15th, which will be episode 600, and that'll be 29 days away. And just like I said, it's 1 week till Christmas, and 2 weeks until we say goodbye to 2021, and turn around and say, hello, 2022. Hope you are a better year for a lot of us. So, let's get to it. Well done. David writes, the school where my son Brian coaches football lost the state title game in a hard-fought battle. Their opponent was undefeated over the past 2 years. I sent Brian a text to commiserate with him and received a terse response, kids battled. No coach shamed the players after the game. No one shouted at them for their mishaps or bad decisions along the way. No coaches showered the young players with praise of what could be praised. So along the same vein, it is good to know that believers in Jesus will not hear harsh words of condemnations from him. When Christ comes and we stand before him, he won't shame us. He'll see what we've done as we followed him. 2 Corinthians 5:10, Ephesians 6:8. I think he'll say something like, you battled, well done. The Apostle Paul testified that he had fought the good fight and looked forward to being welcomed by God. 2 Timothy 4:7 and 8. So life is a relentless struggle with a fierce, unyielding foe devoted to our destruction. He will resist every effort we make to be like Jesus and to love others. There'll be a few good wins and some heartbreaking losses. God knows, but there will be no eternal condemnation for those in Jesus. Romans 8 verse 1. So if we stand before him in the merits of God's Son, each one will receive his praise from God. 1 Corinthians 4 verse 5. And we will receive that message at the judgment day, or when all of us get to heaven and we are found our names are found in the book of life, in the Lamb's book of life. God sees it and he shall say, well done, thy good and faithful servant. Enter into heaven. If most of us survive or are allowed to stay alive until that day. But some of us may not. Some of us may receive a message like that when we cross over Jordan and get to the pearly gates, and whoever is the welcoming committee gets there, says, "Well done, thy good and faithful servant. Welcome home. Enter into glory land." But only certain ones will know. But once we've received that message, then our loved ones who have gone before will be standing there waiting on us when we enter those gates. And our loved ones will run to us and welcome us home. What a day that will be. And every day it gets more and more joyful to go to heaven, to get to heaven, because you got a lot more waiting there for you than you did the other day. Like, yes, I've got grandmothers and family members there, but now I get to see my brother again once I get to heaven. My brother will be waiting for me. My grandmother, my grandfather, somebody I didn't know hardly ever. My mom's mom and her dad, I never got to experience growing up with him. He passed away before I even turned 5. So I never got to fully experience him more than my brother did. But let's think about that for a minute. Does the thought of standing before God fill you with dread or delight? Delight and dread. I dread it a little bit, but not much. Not too much. What would make the difference? I couldn't answer that one, but I have no answer for that part. But ponder on those questions by saying this: thank you, God, for the promise that because I have Jesus as my Savior, I'll never be condemned. So your Bible reading today in this one is the book of Obadiah, which is one chapter, and the book of Revelation, chapter 9. So coming up in tomorrow's, your Sunday, December 19th, part 2 of episode 572, we're going to be remembered in prayer from Patricia Rayburn, derived from Genesis 30, 1 and 2, verses 1 and 2 and 22-24. So stay tuned for that. There is no turning point tonight. That's why this is an evening thing. But your next video, which will be tomorrow's morning video, we are going to be episode 572, part 1, your Days of Praise passage. We're going to be, for Sunday, December the 19th, 2021, we are going to have faith self-defined, beginning with Hebrews 11, verse 13. So stay tuned to that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes. But you'll see that the next video, which will be in the morning at after 8. So, but until then, thanks for watching. I love you. I appreciate you. Keep on keeping on and trusting God, and He'll keep you safe in all you say and do. And until tomorrow, peace out, everybody. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your jubilant Saturday evening. Come back tomorrow for another Lord's Day Sunday. And we'll see what we have in store for tomorrow. But until then, see ya. Goodbye.